Hello, my name is Joseph Lelli from the University of Michigan Department of Nuclear Engineering and Radiological Science. My advisor is Professor Zhang He, and my project is the 4Pi camera for 3D radiation detector imaging. And the camera is designed for a 3D semiconductor radiation detector. Now, this differs from normal radiation detectors in that it provides a directional data for the radiation, as well as, you know, intensity and energy level data. Now, we're going to, in order to take advantage of this functionality, we are planning on designing a imaging system wherein we can take a 4Pi image. Now, what that means is an image that's completely around the detector and completely above and below the detector, so you get a full view of the room, and that's called 4pi because it subtends an angle of 4pi steradians. And in order to do this, we will use two fisheye lens cameras placed back to back, and we will write a computer program that will take two snapshots from fisheye cameras, just flatten them and stitch them together to form a panorama. Fisheye lenses provide fields of view of 180 degrees or greater, and they work by basically taking the hemispherical view around the fisheye lens and projecting it onto a 2D circular image, pretty similar to map projection. There's several different kinds of projections. Equidistant is the most common among newer lenses and what is present in our fisheye lenses. You can get an example of a fisheye image here with the coordinate system drawn on. You can see these sort of lines of longitude. Again, similar to what you'd find on a map, those correspond to the azimuthal angles. Similarly, these lines of longitude correspond to the polar angles. And these equations are used to project the spherical image onto this rectangular image. And we will be using these to make a panorama that we will be able to use in our detector. Here are some fisheye lens images. And here's the panorama that we make using the software. The x coordinates correspond to the azimuthal angles, and the y coordinates correspond to the polar angles. So we can use data directly from the detector. Once it's integrated into the imaging software, looks something like this. You know, we have that polar angle, azimuthal angle, we have the intensity. So this operates at roughly 2 frames per second, depending on the quality of the image desired. You can adjust the exposure time and the contrast to get the picture looking the way you want it. And this is how it looks with the radiation data projected onto the screen. So this is, you can tell how useful this would be, because you can just tell at a glance, even if you don't know anything about radiation detection, you can tell at a glance where in the room that a source of radiation would be just by looking at this. This could be used for national security purposes, you know, port security, detecting the movement of radioactive material, as well as border security. They're also useful for the cleanup of radioactive contamination. Just place the detector in an area, and you can very quickly and easily get a picture of where all the sources of radioactivity are in the room. And I believe that this technology, as it's developed, because, you know, 3D semiconductor detectors are not very common right now, but I feel as we developed, I think that their functionality is demonstrated here will make them a viable option for radiation detection.